Alright, what's up, y'all? So everybody knows that I'm a big Tomb Raider fan, and that's been since the original on the PlayStation 1 all the way up to, you know, the reboot in 2013, even though there were some hit and miss Tomb Raiders in between. But I still stand by my choice, which I often get criticized for, that the Tomb Raider reboot was my game of the year for 2013. But that doesn't mean that I'm not still very critical of Tomb Raider when it needs to be. So this is my impressions for Shadow of the Tomb Raider, having played an estimated maybe 5-6 hours, and the game claims that I have about 25% of it completed. So the story of the Tomb Raider reboot trilogy has been its biggest criticism, apart from the game that came out in 2013, which did a very good job at reintroducing Lara as a character. That game got very high praise all around. Rise of the Tomb Raider didn't do the greatest job of progressing Lara's growth, but it was still a great game. As far as I can tell so far, Shadow of the Tomb Raider seems to be just another entry in the series rather than another piece of Lara's evolution as a character and becoming the Tomb Raider, because as we've learned, this trilogy that we're going through right now with Lara is all three games of her still becoming the Tomb Raider, right? But hopefully, you know, that changes by the end of the game, and this hopefully won't just be another entry in the series, and something drastic will happen to change the narrative that we actually feel like, okay, she is now the Tomb Raider, and it was worth waiting three games for her to finally become that. But, you know, gotta get to the end of the game to see how it turns out. So in this entry, Lara is on another journey to find an ancient artifact that holds immense power, you know, before the evil organization Trinity does. So we've kind of seen this song and dance before. It's kind of similar to the premise of the previous game. But like I said, this is just the first impressions. I obviously haven't beat the game. We'll see how that turns out. Hopefully more will be revealed, like about Trinity, about Lara's parents, specifically her father, and kind of bring the trilogy full circle. So that's pretty much the, you know, the plot so far. But I gotta just really give a real shout out to Jonah, because this character has to be one of the biggest wastes of space and computations ever designed as a character. He's just annoying, boring, and he adds nothing to the story or game. He's just pretty much a generic companion character, right? And I'm sorry, I gotta say, when it comes to making a good surrounding cast of characters and NPCs, listen, I'm gonna need y'all to go hit up Naughty Dog and ask them how to do it. Go ahead and ask Naughty Dog how to create a supporting cast of characters that the player actually cares about. Because honestly, I would give this game damn near an extra point if they just kill off Jonah. I do not know why he's in this game, and I absolutely despise him. But let's move on and talk a little bit about the visuals and the technical performance of Tomb Raider. So I got the game early. I'm playing on PC, and I have a GTX 1080 and, you know, 7700K for anybody who's interested. I received the game code early, as I said, and the game drivers were not released yet, right? Obviously, because I got it early, so I did not get the best results. I was playing at 1440p and ultra settings, and I was getting between 55 and 65 frames, with a little bit of micro stuttering, depending on the screen activity. After the game drivers were released, and I actually turned the settings down from ultra to pretty much high. I only really had put it on ultra to do some like benchmarking. Playing it high is still fine for me. And now I'm getting between, I would say, mostly between 65 and 80, mostly like staying in the 70s. But I still feel like the game can be a little bit more optimized, right? The game is beautiful, though. You know, this setting is a tropical jungle environment. Even though I did like, you know, the cold setting of Siberia in the last game, I don't know, it was just more aesthetically pleasing to me. But there's lush terrains and, you know, beautiful green environments. You know, very nice use of, you know, lighting, shadows, and reflections, especially in the tombs. But this game is lacking in the physics department, as we've seen prior to the game's release. You know, as far as how Lara interacts with the water and how the water behaves. Oh, perfect timing. I just did a dive and the water pretty much didn't even move. The biggest flaw I've noticed visually is when something is applied to Lara's character model. For example, dirt or mud on Lara's face appears to be a flat texture rather than a raised object on top of her skin. And this is disappointing because there are games that have come out years ago that we've seen do a better job at applying something to the character's skin. So, you know, I do think that they're definitely, you know, lacking in that department. And even though the character models are pretty good, they're lacking detail. Lara's skin almost seems clay-like, right? It almost seems pretty kind of flat and dull. You don't really see any imperfections highlighted in her skin, like maybe a wrinkle. You know, we all have a certain level of detail and facial features in our skin, but her just seems to be kind of like a flat textured face. Lara damn near looks like she could be a fucking model. I mean, of course, you know, she is meant to be beautiful, but if you actually look at her skin, it looks like she hasn't been through shit, I guess is what I'm saying. So there's just lack of, like, you know, just showing any flaws or imperfections in her skin that I definitely feel should be there. You know, there should be just be a higher level of detail. This could be, you know, as far as like the mud or dirt or anything on top of her face, this could be like a tessellation issue, which of course I do have on, but I'm not completely sure. But, you know, other than that, bloom, volumetric lighting, and ambient occlusion are all very well utilized in the game. There is an option for pure hair, which I guess is supposed to replace Hairworks, but, you know, none of us really care about that. That's just a gimmick. Gameplay. Gameplay is where I feel Tomb Raider really shines, where it has a lot of depth. In each entry, I feel there's been a greater emphasis on stealth and giving you more tools to kill enemies without being seen. And I'm the type of gamer that loves that. Only thing I love more than an actual dedicated stealth game is a game that gives you the choice on how you want to play, but still has very deep stealth mechanics, because I damn near feel like I'm exploiting the game because of how I utilize, you know, the stealth elements. So, for example, you can cover yourself in mud, so it's harder for enemies to spot you. You can hang enemies from trees, kind of like how Batman hung enemies from statues in the Arkham series. There is more environment from you to attack enemies from, such as walls full of mud or leaves. There's a pretty expansive skill tree to unlock more abilities, different weapons, like her bow, of course, shotgun, pistol, assault rifles, and there are different models of all of these types of guns that can be customized and upgraded. Hunting and finding resources is important and allows you to craft tools on the fly, like Molotovs or bombs. And also, those same resources can be used to craft outfits, which have perks or benefits like bonus XP on kills. They can also make it harder for enemies to see you. Tombs, because this is Tomb Raider. Tombs and puzzles are important because inside everyone gives you some type of incentive that gives Lara an advantage. And it's also an opportunity to unlock a lot more XP, which you need to unlock more of her skills. The game started out slow, I will say that. But when they start giving you more control is when I really started to enjoy it. And there does seem to be a lot more narrative, which sometimes interrupts the gameplay more than I'm used to in a Tomb Raider game. But nevertheless, I am enjoying this game. I do think it's a lot of fun. There are a lot of story concepts in this game that do seem original. And if you play this game, you're going to get up to a certain part and it's going to make you think of a certain other thing in another game. I don't want to spoil it, but you're going to know it exactly when you come to it. You're going to know exactly what I'm talking about. And you're going to be like, this is just like that game. But that is my first impression for Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I will do a review when I finally beat the game. Thank you all for watching. Make sure you hit the like button to support. And I'm out of here. Peace.